most of them are now open up and more of a democratic system. So they also open for trade more, to invest more, to more cross-border traveling, and that bring to the growth. Many countries are opening up, so the people will consume a lot more than before, and that probably led to good growth. And secondly, in Asia Pacific, there quite a number of people country that they are very innovative or high entrepreneurship. So more or less, they try to do better, and they cooperate too. In terms of risks, I think more of the regulatory, some of the regulatories protecting their own economy or infrastructure. A lot of countries in Asia Pacific still need more road, more rail, more telecom, things like that. I think most of the countries still need education, or income gap is another one. After a long 10, 15 years continuous growth, right now probably they will have to really adjust their cost of labor, cost of manufacturing start to be very high. So I think they in a transition process that they need to do something else. In the short term, I think 1 to 3 years, they should more concentrate on domestic economy, because they cannot let the growth too low due to people will have to find a job. And another period, we'll see more Chinese going overseas, especially into Asian countries or ASEAN country, to invest more, like we see now in Thailand or in Myanmar, in Laos, for example. Because of the a lot of population, they have high consumption, and they can also have very high workforce, a lot of natural resources. So good base to go. The area that they have to emphasize probably less subsidy to the people, because like gas or oil or electricity. And the other is the infrastructure. They need a lot more road, more rail, things like that. In Indonesia, I think most of the business that we have there are quite good. Challenges will be on the regulation, that they have quite detailed regulation, some changing regulation. But we adapt to it, and we want to be fully compliant. So the challenge is how to make it fully compliant in Indonesia, and study the trend of the regulations. We really focus in this area, the Asia Pacific region, because we believe in the growth of the economies and the democratic system each country has. We look to invest more in Indonesia, in Thailand, in Laos, in this area, in the ASEAN country, because ASEAN is opening up in as an economic community in 2015. So it looks to be very, very positive, especially Indochina, like Thailand, Myanmar, Cambodia, Vietnam. So we look to that this area. So more or less, they will have certain control, some kind of policy, for example, like foreign investment level not exceeding 50% in the longer term, or some of the labor that we import to use, they have certain control on it. These factors we take into account how we make investment. If it put a lot of pressure on our return or risks, then we would have very good consideration to invest less in that particular country. We have own port in Indonesia for seaport, for the coal loading, and some ports in Australia that we have secured the tonnage, the right to export. We have the rail, we have the barge, we have the own hauling load. So what we need to invest more probably into expansion, a better utilization or synchronization, optimization. And sometimes it involves IT or mobile technology to help.